Good morning, and we are continuing with our lesson on insurance. We have learned about what insurance is, so you know it as a contract, and we also said it's a pooling of risks, and so forth, and so on and so forth. We have also talked about some terms that we use in learning insurance. And the key ones I said you should take note or particular notice of were the insurable risks, uninsurable risks at one side, indemnity insurance and non-indemnity insurance at the other side. Then we also talked about the difference between insurance and assurance. Today we are continuing with the lesson on a very simple subtopic, and that is the procedure that one goes through when one wants to take an insurance policy. So I said procedure for taking an insurance policy, and I've applied some key words here. That means that these words are very important. When you are talking about the procedure, for example, you are asked to talk about the procedure for taking insurance policy. These are some of the things the examiner will be looking out for, some of the key words. So when you are describing it, when you are talking about anything, it is important for you to note the key words. For example, if you were describing how a company is formed, there are certain key words the examiner will be expecting from you. So you will not just be writing a story, but there are certain key things that are very important. So if you look at what you see on the board, the first thing is that the one seeking to be employed, and these words we have already dealt with almost 90% or even more than that when we are talking about the terms that are used. So the first thing you need to do, you are the one seeking to be insured, and you are called the proposer. So what you do is that you have to walk to an insurance company. So any insurance company that you think is good for you or have the policy in respect of the property or whatever you want to insure or assure, you go there. So the proposer will go to the insurance company. Or these insurance companies too, you see, we have that agency. They have agents who go around to, just even yesterday, an insurance agent came to a school to talk to teachers about some policies. So you can decide, the insurance agent can come to you, and then he talks to you, he presents to you a lot of policies. So whichever you are interested in, you can decide to buy that particular policy. So the proposer will go to the insurance company, or you see the agent. When you go, they will, if you don't understand the policy would be explained to you. Please know that if you don't understand anything in respect of insurance, it's a contract. So let either the agent or whoever you met and responsible at the office explain the policy to you. If you have questions, ask the questions. So when that has been done, then the proposal form that we have already learned, and I showed a sample of Quality Insurance Company Limited owed to you, you'll be given depending on the policy you want to buy, you'll be given the proposal form and you fail the form. As you fail the proposal form, there is something you need to take note of. You have to take note of what we call the principle of utmost good faith. The principle of utmost good faith as you are filling the proposal form. Whatever information that is given on the form, you have to be truthful. You tell them the truth. Whatever question you are asked, there's no need lying on the form. Because if you do that, you may live to regret it. The unfortunate event may occur, and the insurance company might not compensate you because of that misrepresentation or misdescription, as we learned in our previous lesson. So you need to be truthful. So this principle says that you have to be truthful. You should give them every material fact. Every fact that is material. When they, in law or in insurance, when they say a fact is material, it means that any statement that you give to the insurance company, that will enable them to determine the right premium you are supposed to pay. Know that it is not because you have a filling station or a fuel station, you go and then they tell you that pay this premium. You may have a fuel station or filling station, another person may have it. The two of you might go to an insurance company to insure, and you may pay more premium than the person. Probably where yours is located, if you have gone for fire insurance, the probability, the tendency of your station, your filling station catching fire might be higher than that of that person. And therefore, you pay more premium than the person. So, whatever description you need to give, the principle of utmost good faith should work. So, in filling the form, be truthful when you are filling the form. When you have done that, you know the actuaries have calculated the premium supposed, or they will calculate the premium to be paid. So you pay your first premium and the policy starts. But when the policy starts, you see the that document, that policy, that contract you have entered into, where you have agreed to pay a certain amount that you call premium, and they have also agreed to indemnify you. To indemnify. So if it is to, then this one will go and it will indemnify. So to indemnify you. That means they will restore you back to your former position. The policy will not be ready on that day. It's like you are going for a car of vehicle license from DVLA. When you go, the license, after you have gone through everything, the test, the exams, whatever, and you are through and you qualify to be given the license will not be given to you that day, because they cannot prepare the license for you that day. It takes time. It can take 3 months before they can give to you. So what they need to give to you is what they call the cover note, which you use on temporary basis, so that if any policeman meets you and then you are asked, where is your third party insurance, then you can show. I'm not even talking about the third party, I'm talking about the license. So where is your license? Then you show the policeman the cover note. The moment the policeman sees the cover note, he knows you have gone for your license, except that it is not, the card is not ready to be issued. In the same way, when you go for the insurance policy, the policy will not be ready at that material moment. So you'll be given the cover note, which will be used on temporary basis, so that when the policy is ready, after some time, after some few months, when the policy is ready, then the policy will be given to you, and you will no more be using the cover note. So now, the policy has started, you have had your policy. So the next thing is that if the unfortunate event happens, then you will go for the claim form, then they will give to you, you fill it, they will determine the extent of damage, and then you will be indemnified. So that is the procedure you go through when you want to insure your property. You want to take any insurance policy. Generally, that is what you do. You go to the insurance company or an agent who explains the policy to you. If you are okay with it, you are giving the proposal form to fill. And I've told you that when you are filling the form, the principle of utmost good faith should work. You need to be truthful. You don't lie about your age and any other question that you are asked. If it is about health issues, do you have this disease, this sickness? If you have it, let them know that you have it. If you don't have it, you say no. You answer all the questions faithfully. When you have done that one, you will be required to pay your first premium. After paying it, you are giving the government on temporary basis. After which, when the policy itself is ready, you are giving. Remember, the cover note was given to you so that in the event of the occurrence of the risk, you can present it that you have insured your property or whatever against whatever risk. And then this is it. Then if you don't, you didn't have the policy, you present the cover note. If you have the policy, you present the policy and then you have your claim. So that brings us to the end of this simple subtopic, the procedure you go through in taking insurance policy. Thank you. We shall continue on another video with the principles of insurance. Meet you another day. Thank you.